Are we open to Exodus chapter 20? Exodus chapter 20. Be active tonight. Anything can happen. Exodus chapter 20, verse number 1 to 6. Exodus chapter 20, verse 1 to 6. Today we have a teaching session. I read from the NIV version. It says, and God spoke all these words. Verse 2. I am the Lord your God who brought you out of Egypt, out of the land of slavery. You shall have no gods. You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not make for yourself an idol in the form of anything in heaven above or on earth beneath or in the waters below. You shall not bow down to them or worship them. For I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, punishing the children for the sin of the fathers to the third and fourth generation of those who hate me, but showing love to 1,000 generations of those who love me and keep my commandments. Hallelujah. I'm teaching this evening on the subject, stop idol worship. Can we say stop idol worship?
Stop idol worship.
Someone say stop idol worship.
Stop idol worship.
Can we all say stop idol worship? Hallelujah.
Amen.
I say hallelujah.
Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, follow me this evening. I want you to be active this evening. Stop idol
worship.
Again, stop idol
worship.
Ladies and gentlemen, follow me very well. You see, friends, an aircraft is simply a means of transportation. Hallelujah.
Amen.
An aeroplane is a means of transportation that can transport a person from a point A to a point B. But you see, ladies and gentlemen, an aeroplane does not take off without speed. Someone say speed.
Speed.
I cannot hear. Say speed.
Speed.
If you have, someone say speed.
Speed.
An aeroplane does not take off without speed. So there should be a taking off in order to be a departure. If there's no taking off, there is no departure. If there's no departure, you cannot. There's no arrival. So if there is departure, there must be arrival. If there is departure, there must be arrival. So the what the aircraft does is they simply activate it because it cannot take off without speed. And ladies and gentlemen, when the aircraft gets on the runway, it doesn't start running like that. They must check to make sure that the runway is clear. Ladies and gentlemen, the plane will start moving, and at the point in time, the sound will change. The sound will change. Why? Because the speed has been activated. If the aircraft does not move with speed, it cannot become lighter. And if it is not lighter, it cannot take off. Friends, I want to submit to you this evening, there are some things that makes believers not to take off. There are some things that makes a family not to take off. There are some things that makes a person not to take off. What are those things? Number one, idol worship is weight. It's weight because when an aircraft does not move fast, it cannot take off. What makes it to take off? Yes, there must be weight. Yes, weight is there. But in the airport, they make sure that they calculate the luggage. Yes, there are excess luggage, but there's a limit. We cannot oversee. But ladies and gentlemen, idol worshiping has overseeded the weight, has overseeded the cargo, has overseeded the limit of weight. Ladies and gentlemen, when you're an idol worshiper, you cannot take off from the ground. When you're an idol worshiper, you cannot take off even as a believer, which means that if you cannot take off, you cannot arrive at your destination. And God has made you, to arrive at a particular place at an appointed time. But sin is an iniquity. Ladies and gentlemen, when there's idol worshiping, your income cannot take off, your family cannot take off. Tonight, as you cut off from idol worship, may the Holy Ghost elevate you.
Yeah.
I say, may the Holy Ghost elevate you.
Yeah.
Friends, stop idol worship, because when you're idol worshiper, you cannot take off. An idol worshiper stays stagnant. Because idol worshiping is excess baggage. Are we together? The Bible says, let every sin that is beseech you. So idol worshiping is a sin that beseech people. So when you're idol worshiper, your aircraft will never take off. And if it doesn't take off, you can never arrive. And God has created you with all the potentials, with all the skill. He says, see thou a man diligent in his business, he shall see before kings, not before men. You must take off in order to be seen by kings. You must take off in order power to receive by men who are worthy. Tonight, as you leave under worshiping, may the Holy Ghost take you off.
Amen.
I said, may the Holy Ghost elevate you.
Amen.
I said, may you take off tonight. May you take off tonight. May you take off tonight. You can take off physically. You can take off spiritually. May you take off spiritually tonight. Let your amen sound like thunder in this house. In charge. Say my neighbor. Say my neighbor. Stop idol worship. My neighbor. Say my neighbor. Stop idol worship. It is excess baggage. It is sin before God. Say my neighbor. Idol worshiping is sin and is excess baggage. So for me, I'm not saying it. I say my neighbor. Idol worship. In excess baggage, which can never be paid for, even at the airport, it will be rejected. There are some packages at the airport that are rejected. Even you want to pay extra, they say no. This one, no, we cannot. Wait for the next aircraft. Hallelujah. Someone say, my neighbor. Stop idol worship. Hallelujah. Ladies and gentlemen, follow me very well. This morning, we'll be looking at the subject, examine your foundation. You see, the Bible says in the book of Psalms 11 verse 3, it says, if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? So there are some things that when they are deployed into your foundation, even though you are righteous, you are speaking in tongues, there's nothing you can do. Are we together? It says, if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? We are examining our foundation, our father's ashes. Friend, I want to submit to you that our foundations are bad. I want to submit to you that our father mother's houses, if you check the foundation spiritually, they are not of God. They are of the devil. Are we together? I submit to you. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah. Because this year they say tradition, mother's tradition, father tradition. All the traditions, as I know, all centered around idol worship. All the tradition, whether father mother's house, all the traditions of our father mother's houses, they centered around idol worship. Are we together?
Yes, sir.
Someone say neighbor.
Neighbor.
I can hear you. Say neighbor.
Neighbor.
Stop idol worship.
Stop idol worship.
Say neighbor.
Neighbor.
Stop idol worship.
Stop idol worship.
Hallelujah. So let's just follow me. The Bible says in Genesis chapter number 12 verse 1. It said, the Lord said to Abraham, leave thy country. Because I want to teach. The Lord said to Abraham, leave thy country. Leave thy people. Leave thy countrymen or your father's house. Leave them. Why did God tell Abraham to leave? Because if you can go back to the history of Abraham, Abraham's father was called Terah. Are we together? And Terah was an idol maker and an idol worshiper. He was making idols and he was worshiping idols. So Abraham came from the lineage of idol worshippers. So God could not deal with him in that background or in that foundation. There must be a change of foundation before God can deal with the man. That's why God is a covenant keeping God. So evil foundation, they come with evil covenants. Are we together? So God told Abraham, leave your father's house. Leave your country, I understand. Leave your people, okay. He said, leave your father's house. Means if you don't step out of your father's foundation, Abraham, you can never be blessed. Are we together? So in Genesis 12 verse 1, he said, after you leave your father's house, then verse 2 says, then I will make your name great. So some of you, your name has not yet become great because you are still standing on your father's foundation. You are still operating from your household foundation. Are we together? So unless you leave your household foundation and go to a place, another foundation, which Christ has laid, there is no other foundation other than the one Christ has laid. For Jesus Christ is a sure foundation. So we have a sure foundation which is built on Christ, and we have the foundation of our father's house. You see, most of us are still tied to our father's tradition. If you are still a traditional person, which means that you are tied to your foundation. You might be speaking in tongues. You might see you're born again. You might not be experiencing blessing, nor breakthroughs, nor hearing God, nor seeing. Right, check by the word, you are still operating from your father's foundation. And your father's foundation might be a foundation of witchcraft. It might be a foundation of polygamy. It might be a foundation of idol worship. And God does not condone with that. For God does not share his glory. He said, I am the Lord, your God. Are we together? So he told Abraham, leave your father's house. Why? Because God understands that if Abraham came from a family of idol worshiping, therefore Abraham will surely be worshiping idols as well. So if Abraham is worshiping idols, how can you say you are worshiping God, meanwhile you are worshiping idols? Are we together? You can never be an idol worshiper and a true worshiper of God in spirit and in truth. It's not possible. Ladies and gentlemen, I submit to you. It's not possible. You cannot say you are worshiping idols of your father's house, idols of your mother's house, and you say, I am a believer. I am worshiping God in spirit and in truth. It's not possible. You have to choose who you have to serve. Either you serve God in spirit and in truth, or you serve the idols of your father's house. But remember, God said, I am a jealous God. I will visit the father's iniquity on the children, on the third and the fourth generation, to those who hate me. So some of the things you are going through today is not because you caused them. You are just paying for the price the third and fourth generation paid. Whatever they did that hurt God, you are paying for it today. That's why, ladies and gentlemen, if you don't change your foundation, you might pay for the sins of your forefathers. If you don't change your foundation and come to Christ with your hand, you might pay. He said, I visit the iniquities of the father upon the children to the third and the fourth generation. Check your father, check your grandfather, check your great-grandfather, check and go back. You discover that their lives were not okay before God. Therefore, what you are going through is not strange because you are operating from a foundation. Are we together? I'm serving together. Someone say, talk to me. So he said, Abraham, for me to make your name great, for me to bless you, for you to be a blessing, you must leave your father's house. Because if Abraham had to stay there, he would follow his father's tradition. He would follow his mother's tradition. And you know, that's the main idols, and they sold it, and they were making money from that. It was their business as well, and it was their culture of worship. So Abraham could have followed like father, like son. He could have followed the footsteps of Terah to also make idols, to earn money, and also worship the idols. Therefore, you discover that God cannot make his name great. Likewise, God is telling us today that the Bible said, for anyone who is in Christ, in Christ, which means that you cannot be in Christ as you're operating on the foundation of your father, mother's houses. Are we together? Let me be more practical tonight. You cannot say, I am standing in Christ on the sure foundation. Meanwhile, you are still pouring libation. You didn't get me? You cannot say, you are standing on Christ Jesus. I am a born again. I am born again. But you are still invoking, ancestral spirit. You are still an idol worshiper. God does not know you. Not that God says, on that day, he will say to them, depart from me, you workers of iniquity. But I was serving, I was worshiping you. And he said, look at this one. You are an idol worshiper. God knows you though. Someone says, neighbor. Say, neighbor. Stop idol worship. Say, neighbor. Stop idol worship. So in Genesis chapter 1, verse 1, the Bible says, in the beginning, God. In the beginning, Elohim. Exodus chapter number 20, verse 3. It says, you shall have no other gods before me. Verse 4. You shall not make for yourself idols. You shall not make for yourself idols. An idol can be an object. Your phone can be your idol. You hear me? Your wife can be your idol. Your husband can be your idol. Anything you give more time to other than God, is your idol. Facebook is an idol. Are we together? WhatsApp is an idol. If you spend more time on WhatsApp than Jesus Christ, means that WhatsApp is your idol. Someone say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It says, do not bow down nor worship them. That was why when Haman tried to kill, to terminate the Jews in the book of Esther, the Bible said, Haman prompted Mordecai to bow down. Why should we bow down? Just bow down means that you reverence him. Means Haman was to be seen as a god. He wanted Mordecai and the Jews to know that he's a god. Are we together? But Jehovah said, I am the Lord your God. So Mordecai understood from the books that we are not allowed to worship nor bow down to before any other god. They understood this very well. That's why the three Hebrew guys, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they refused to bow down before the image of Nebuchadnezzar. They said, no, we're not going to bow down. Even if God does not come, we shall not bow down. Why? They understood the place of bowing down before an idol. Because once you bow down before an idol, you become an Once you bow down before an idol, you become useless before God. God rejects you. Are we together? When you bow down before an idol, God rejects you. Because there's something which God will never condone, idol worship. That's why Israelites, they went to captivity. Read the scriptures. They did evil before God. What? Idol was involved. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they refused to bow down to the image of Nebuchadnezzar. They said, we shall put you in the fine furnace. They said, no problem. Even if it means we should die, let's die. But we know that God does not come late. My brothers, God never comes late.
Yes,
I say, never comes late.
Yes,
I say, never comes late. And when they put them, ladies and gentlemen, they look at, I studied science, I studied physics very well. I'm a physicist, I saw physical. He said they should light the fire 7 times. That was just to frighten them. Because they will put figures to frighten you, to frighten your imagination. That because when you're frightened, you will bow down. When you bow down, you'll be killed. Because when you once you bow down, God leaves you and man will kill you. But when you resist, I said no. And no man redeemed liberty. The Bible said they were thrown in the finest furnace. Yes, they stayed there. But the Bible says the whole nation, including they sat down, they were washing. It was a public disgrace to the nation, not to the Hebrew guys, because in the end, the nation and the Nebuchadnezzar, they were disgraced, and these guys were liberated. Why? Because the fourth man showed up. Why the fourth man showed up? I pray for you, may the fourth man show up in your life. May the fourth man show up in your life. I said, may he show up in your life. Somebody shout hallelujah. Sit down and say, I'm in charge. The fourth man showed up. Why? Because they refused to bow to idols. We shall not. The fourth man, the Bible says, Hayakabodobo. Some people call him. They said the AC in the fire. He was the AC in the fire. In the fire furnace. The Bible said, the Nebuchadnezzar said, how many did you put? They said, we put 3. He said, no. I saw 4, but the fourth man looks like the son of God. How did he know the son of God? Ladies and gentlemen, there are 2 things. Either you worship God or you worship idols. Either you worship God or you worship idols. The same thing with Daniel. Daniel refused to succumb. The same thing with Nebuchadnezzar. With Mordecai. If Mordecai had succumbed to bind down to Haman, they could have killed all of them. If Mordecai had accepted to bow down to Haman, they called him Lord Haman. Lord Haman. Lord Haman. A human being is called Lord. Very good. But Jesus is a King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. That's why it says, you shall have no other God before me. So Haman wanted the Jews to see him like a God. Mordecai said, no, I cannot break the commandment of God. I cannot break it. And that is why God showed up. Why? Because a man refused to bow down before a deity. Hallelujah. Someone say hallelujah. In Isaiah chapter number 43 verse 10, Isaiah 43 verse 10, it says, before me no God was formed, nor would there be any other after me. Isaiah 43 verse 10, before me no God was formed. No God, he is Elohim. That's why Jesus says, I am the Alpha and Omega. Means before me there is no God. After me there will be no God, for I am God Almighty. Are we together? So in Isaiah chapter 43 verse 11, he said, I, the Lord, apart from me, there is no other Savior. Apart from Jesus, there is no other Savior. If you go down to verse number 25, he said, I, he who blots out your transgressions of your sins. So what's your neighbor? Stop idol worship. Say neighbor? Stop idol worship. In Isaiah 44 verse 6, it says, I am the first and the last. Apart from me, there is no God. I'm giving you scriptures to see. I am the first and the last. Apart from me, there is no God. Verse 8, you are my witness. Is there any God beside me? Can I ask someone tonight? Is there any God beside Jesus?
No.
You did not hear me. Let me answer this one. Is there any God beside Jesus?
No.
Is there any God beside the Holy Ghost?
No.
He said, I am the Lord your God. Beside me there is no other God. Ladies and gentlemen, above him there is none. Beside there is none. Beneath there is none. All other God and man make God. Jesus is the only real God. He is the only true God. He is the Son of the living God. He is God Almighty. He is Yahweh. He is Ancient of Days. He is the Rock of Ages. He is the El Shaddai. He is the leader of a valley. Beside him, there is no other God. There is no other God. All other gods are mommy gods, including all those of my family and villages. There's no other God apart from Jesus. He is the only living God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I say hallelujah.
Amen.
Isaiah 45 verse 5. He said, I am the Lord and no other God. I am the Lord and there is no other God. If a man says there is no other God, he is sure and certain. He said, I am the Lord. There is no other God. There is no other God. I remember the Bible said in John chapter number 1, in the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. He said, without Him, nothing was made that was made. And then through Him, everything that was made. So the idols in your father's houses, they were made through God. So God has the power to destroy them. Above all, there is no other God. He is Jesus. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Say hallelujah. In Isaiah 46 verse 9, he said, I am God, there is no other God. I am God, there is no other. I am God, and there exists none like me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In Psalm chapter number 115 verse 4 to 8, Psalms 115 verse 4 to 8, Psalms 135 verse 16 to 18, it talks about the foreign gods. They have eyes, but they cannot see. They have mouth, but they cannot speak. They have ear, they cannot hear. They have legs, they cannot move. Ladies and gentlemen, I know a God that has eyes and can see. I know a God that can hear prayers. I know a God, when He speaks, it comes to pass. I know a God, when He moves, nature moves. Ladies and gentlemen, I come to bow to you with all humility of heart. I thank God by the grace I give Him glory. I have seen Jesus 3 times. He appeared to me personally 3 times. I know the God I'm preaching. Beside Him, there is no other God. When you see Him, your life will change. When you see Jesus Christ, you know that really He is the Lord of Lords. When you see Him, when you read the Bible about Him, it's different. But when you see Jesus, when you see Him, He's very tender and loving. When you see Him, someone say, never when you see Him.
Never when you see Him.
Say, never when you see Jesus.
Never when you see Jesus.
What is idolatry? Idolatry is simple word. Let me define it before we continue. Tonight I want us to pray. When we say let's pray, if you're weak, fall, let it fall. Pray. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What is idolatry? Number one, let me define idol. An idol is simply an image. An image, a representation of a God, small g. Jehovah is capital G. Adonai is capital G. Elohim is capital G. The gods in my family, my villages, around this area, they are small g. So He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords and the God of God. He said, apart from me, is there any other God? He said, you are my weakness. I stand as a weakness. There is no other God beside Him. All other gods are man-made gods. That's why He told Abraham, Abraham, leave your father's house. Because whatever is there, He said, those are man-made gods. You took your hand, you sat down on a chair, you chiseled them, you made their hands, you made their faces, you tapped their eyes. Can they speak? No. Can they move? No. So what are we talking about? Jehovah is God Almighty. Someone shout, I hear you. He's the only living God. So an idol is an image, a representation of a small G God used as an object of worship. So what is idolatry? Idolatry means that worship of an idol. When you worship an idol, that's an idolatry. Worship of an idol as though it were God. As though it was Jehovah. As though it was Jesus. Let me say Jesus. Because there are many gods. There are gods which are cows. There are gods, small g. There are goats, there are cows, there are snakes. There are countries that they have gods. It's still is a god, small g. But I have a God who starts with capital G. That's Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And that's the one I stand here to preach. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I say hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, beside me, is there any other God? None like Him. I have never seen the righteous without Him. Why? Because when you trust in God, you can never put to shame. But when you trust in the chariots, when you trust in the idols of your father's son, ladies and gentlemen, your calamities are from the idols of your father's houses, not Jesus. Because you see, the idols, they are there to weigh you down. They are there to destroy. They are there to kill. And they are there to scatter your life. If you stay as an idol worshiper, your life will be shattered, will be scattered, and will be buried. But when you relocate to Jesus, the sure foundation, I can tell you, he's the one that can elevate you. He said, I have made you, I have created you, and I will carry you, carry me to where? Into my destiny. The idols in your father's house cannot carry to your destiny, but they will take you to the kingdom of darkness. The idols in your father's house will put you on the broad road. But Jesus Christ said, I am the way to the Father. Someone say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Someone say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So it can be worship of an idol, and idol can be objects. It can be animals. So people worship cow. Don't kill this cow. Let's not eat cow meat, because that's our God. It's their God, not my God. My God is Jesus Christ. Some people worship the snake. In Egypt, that's why when Moses came and told Ramses, Pharaoh, he said, let my people go. He said, the God of the Hebrews have said, let my people go. He said, what? The God of the Hebrews? I don't know any other God. He said, I, Pharaoh, am a God. He was a small G. And I tell you, I like what God did. Listen, gentlemen, I have a God that knows how to frustrate idols. You don't hear me? I have a God, I serve a God from my heart that knows how to frustrate idols. Pharaoh thought he was an idol. Pharaoh thought he was a God. Yes, yes, because he thought him using the Sephardic powers, him using the marine power. Yes, Pharaoh was controlled by the waters, by the marine, by the serpent. Yes, he thought he was a God. Yes, a serpent is a God of the world. Yes, a small G. I'm talking about Jesus. Jesus is a capital G. Yes, Pharaoh thought he thought he had power. But when Moses came to him, he said, the God of the Hebrews, he has spoken, said, let my people go that they can worship me. Because in Egypt was nothing but idol worship. He said, let them go to a land where they can worship me in spirit and in truth. And Pharaoh said, there is no other God. I like what he did. In the end, when they were moving, God said, I took them out of Egypt, from the land of bondage, from the land of slavery. I took them out to the Canaan land, to the promised land. He said, I took them out that they might go and worship me. And the Bible said, when Ramses, when Pharaoh tried to pursue, to cross the Red Sea, the Bible said he was swallowed in the sea. What? I have a God that when he speaks, when God moves, nature moves. When he moves, nature moves. The Bible said when the glory comes down, he said even the mountains will skip. When the glory came down, the Red Sea parted. I know not God that Jesus Christ, the God in my father's house, they are man-made God. That's why they are stagnant. That's why they are broke. That's why they are poor. That's why they are deadly. Ladies and gentlemen, and if I have an opportunity, I will scatter them. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I said shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I went to a shop one day to buy. Not all the supermarkets you see here are supermarkets. Not all the groceries you see are just groceries. Some of them are cooking pot. I went to a supermarket to buy. I was with my wife, we went there. I told them to weigh something for me. And my wife showed me something. He said, look at that. They put, I don't know whether it's an idol or what, something standing. People, ladies and gentlemen, I don't joke. Call police for me. I didn't steal. I'll justify myself. The God I said, I want to buy something there, and I'm seeing an idol standing, and I'll keep buying. I went there, I carried a hoodie, I took it, I break it. I don't care what I was covered, I break it and I threw it. I said, continue with my thing. Call police for me. Someone said, hallelujah. I'm not telling movie what I did. I went there, I pulled the thing, bam, I break it, I threw it on that. Nonsense. Kabo shita kala. Wait my listen. How many kilos is that? Yes, for the next one. Kalabush. In front of me, I break it. I don't care about the camera. Sometimes you joke with these things, you don't know that's an invocation. You don't know that. It might be a small thing standing, you don't know that this one is a strong one. Life is spiritual, if you don't know that. In this nation, people are using powers for business. You didn't hear me? In this nation, people are using power to get contract. And you're joking. They're using power to make money in this country. I know worshiping is maybe here. You might not know it. Forget about what you see. My face, shine your eyes. What I'm teaching is important. They're using charms to make money in this country. That's part of idol worship. But if Jesus is for you, their charms will fail.
Amen.
I said it 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 will fail.
Amen.
Hear me very well. There are people now that they go to their company accommodations, the owners. They go to their company accommodation in the toilet.
Yes.
An owner of the company will come to visit the accommodation, will not go to the room. He will go back to the toilet. Yes. Do you know why? Ladies and gentlemen, a toilet is a portal to the kingdom of darkness. So anybody that masturbates there, you are gone. Stop masturbation. Stop it. You sin before God. Stop it. Stop it. You sin before God. When you go and masturbate there, you are gone. Your destiny is soul. It has entered the portal to the kingdom of darkness. You are joking. When God says stop it, you say no. Pastor, don't understand. Okay, continue. Which God is will? Let me tell you something. Someone say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Someone say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So, almost all our father's traditions are based on idol worship. Even some of our family names are idols. That's why identities are swallowed. Because when you are named after an idol, your identity is swallowed by the idol. When they call your name at the embassy to give a visa, they are not seen by you, they are seen by a grandmother. Why? An idol. I heard a story. A guy left Africa, got American visa, entered America at the border of entry, at the border to enter. When they checked his passport, they saw his grandmother's picture. You can see physically it is his picture, but spiritually they saw the grandmother. So it was the grandmother's picture that was being projected from the screen. They said, "Who is this?" He says, "My grandmother." What I do with the grandmother's picture or passport? He said, "I don't know." And he was deported back. Why? Because when they looked at him, they saw an idol. A grandmother can be an idol. Your grandfather can be an idol. They can project themselves. Are we together? So sometimes, stop saying, nobody is helping me. No. When they look at you, they are not seeing you. They are seeing the idols your fathers are speaking against you. Nobody is favoring me. No, it's not about that nobody favors you. My friend, search your household very well. You understand what is happening to you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I say hallelujah.
Amen.
What are the consequences? I want us to pray tonight. Hear me, child of God. Number one, Jeremiah 7, verse 24 to 26. What are the consequences of idol worship? Number one, he said they went backward. They went backward and not forward. Jeremiah chapter number 7, verse 24 to 26. He said they went backward. Why did they go backward? Go to verse number 30. He said they went backward because they set idols. Let me teach tonight. He said they went backward and not forward. So any family, any individual that are worshiping idols of any form, they always go backward and not forward. Any individual that worships idols or family or community or nation, they are always backward ever, never forward. Never. Why were they always going backward? Why? God never made us. God does not go backward. God is the God of forward. Fast forward. Are we together?
Amen.
Are we together?
Amen.
God never goes backward. God goes forward ever. He said you shall move from glory to glory to glory, which means that you shall ever increase. So my God, the God I serve, Jesus Christ, he moves from small to the greatest. But the idols of your father's house, they move from the smallest to nothing. Ladies and gentlemen, hear me very well. So you see that they always move backward and never forward. Why? In verse number 30. Verse 30 says, because they send idols. So idols bring families or individuals to the place of bondage and they move backward in life. Spiritually, financially, monetarily, business-wise, all facets. Check it, if you are backward in life, it's an idol involved. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Verse 30 says, because they set idols. Because when they set idols, they worship idols. And anywhere that there's idol worshiping, there must be altars. Because an idol is set on an altar. And it's not just what you see, you're dealing here with spirits. The idol is backed up by a spirit. Are we together?
Yes, sir.
Are we together?
Yes,
so every idol is backed up by a spirit. So when you worship an idol, the Bible said they move backward. Are you moving backward? Check your father's foundation. You might be an idol worshiper. If you are moving backward, check. Hallelujah. So the first consequence is they move backward. Backward in finances, in business, in marriage, in life, academic, everything is backward. Say this man, you are backward all the time. Check, that man is worshiping idols. That's what the Bible says. Number two,
unanswered prayers. Have you gotten all your answers? If yes, God bless you. If no, God is saying unanswered prayers is they are one of the results of idol worship is unanswered prayers. John chapter 10 verse 31. John 10 31 says, for we know that God does not answer sinners. Jeremiah 7 verse 16. Unanswered prayers. Jeremiah 7 verse 16. And especially Jeremiah 14 verse 11. Jeremiah 14 verse 11. Jeremiah 14, 11. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are we learning something tonight?
Yes, sir.
So let me read from the NIV version. Jeremiah 14, 11 says, then the Lord said to me, do not pray for the well-being of these people. Did you hear that? Do not pray for their well-being. Do not pray for them. Don't pray for their well-being. Don't pray for their marriage. Don't pray for their health. Don't pray for their business. Why? He said, verse 12. He said, although they fast, I will not listen to their cry. Though they offer burnt offerings and grain offerings. Why? Because they set idols and they are worshiping idols. Jesus does not answer people who worship idols. Scriptures. Yeah, a lot of them. I don't want to waste time. Number three. Blockages. We're looking at consequences of worshiping idols. Number one, they always go backward. Number two, unanswered prayers. Number three, blockages which can be spiritual or physical. They can be physical blockages. They can be spiritual blockages. And when there are blockages, there will be struggles. And when there are struggles, there will be stagnation. And then when stagnation, there is backward. Because time is moving ahead, the person is moving backward. Are we together?
Yes,
blockages. Jeremiah 6 verse 21. He said, I will put obstacles before these people. I will put obstacles before these people. Ladies and gentlemen, anybody that worship idols, Jesus Christ never answered their prayers. For Jesus doesn't share his glory with any man. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah.
Amen.
I say hallelujah.
Amen.
Blockages. So when you're experiencing blockages in your life, check your foundation. Check, are you an idol worshiper or you're a worshiper of Jesus Christ? You can never worship idols and worship Christ the same. It's not possible. Many of us in church, we call ourselves born again. We speak in tongues, but we are still idol worshippers. Let me be honest with you. Many people camouflage in church. They masquerade. Speaking in tongues doesn't mean that you're born again. Hello? Do you hear me? You can speak in tongues, but you're not born again. Born again is a lifestyle that pleases God. That pleases Jesus Christ. If anyone, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, a born again is a new creation. Means that if somebody was a drunkard yesterday and he say I'm born again, he should stop drinking. But if that person still drinks alcohol, he's not born again, he's born against. You didn't get me? You didn't get me? If anybody was involved in Yahoo yesterday and he received Christ today, he said I'm born again. And if he still continues in Yahoo, he's not born again, he's born again. Because born again is a change of mindset. Repentance, when you repent means I've changed my mindset for things. Change of mindset, repentance. From what? Many things. From life entirely, from the worldly things to God. I've changed my mindset from the worldly standard. I've left the world. Now, Lord, I am with you. Jesus, I am with you. But there are people in church today, ladies and gentlemen, who are saying, I don't worship us. Ladies and gentlemen, don't deceive. You can deceive men, but you can never deceive God. God knows us all. He sees everything. And we shall all be rewarded on that day. Someone said, hear you. Say, mama, say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Stop.
Stop.
I don't worship.
I
cannot hear you. Say, neighbor. Say, neighbor.
Stop.
I don't worship. So he put obstacles on their way. Breakthroughs are not coming. Why? The idols are swallowing the breakthrough. Listen, gentlemen. Idols can swallow certificates. They swallow money. They swallow effort and skills. Idols. Now remember, how did this come about? If you look at in those days,
Our great grandparents, they used to look for solutions because there used to be tribal wars, even within the village or community. There used to be a lot of conflicts. So they were looking for an avenue, a deity that can appease people or they can depend on for protection. Some of them went to the god of the forest. Some people, they worship the god of the forest. Are we together? Some people are talking right now, they worship snake in Africa. In their company, you can see snake. They say, no, that's our god. Don't kill it. They worship snake. Some, they have called a carving image of calf. They have special houses. Are we together? So they went for these things in those days. They never knew that. They thought that they were worshiping God. They thought the devil is deceptive and crafty. They thought they were worshiping God. They never knew that they took the family out of Christianity, out of Christ, into the place of idol worship. And the consequences are on the children to the grandchildren. And there are some of you that are foreign traditions. My favorite tradition, the pastor don't understand. By prophecy, one time when there was a word of prophecy, there was a young man in the choir. I don't want to call his name. There was a young man in the choir doing the prophetic move. The Lord spotted him. He said, this one. He said, tell him not to send that money. I was like, how is it? He said, tell him not to send that money. He gave me, I saw $100. I thank the Holy Ghost, he speak to me. Thank God I hear him and I see. Thank God. If not, I could have been killed long time. Because there are people that come to church to kill, to steal and destroy the pastor. You didn't hear me? I said, didn't hear me? You did not hear me. So by prophecy, the Lord showed me that $100 was to be sent from this guy to his family in December. Very clear. Why? He gave the reason. Because the guy wants his family to service his own altar. That thing should be working for him here. And he's in the choir lifting his hand. Even leading songs. We worship you, Lord. You are worthy to be praised. You are worshiping the idols of your father have, not Jehovah. You cannot be worshiping idols your father house, and you say, you come to Jesus, say, I worship you, O Lord. You are worthy. He's not worthy to be praised to an idol worshiper. Either you worship God or you worship the gods of your father's houses. Period. I told him, don't send that money. It was in church. Sometimes when the Holy Ghost carries me, it's like, I don't even know. I don't understand something. Sometimes you see me, sometimes you can't. I don't even understand what's happening. When it comes on me like that, my eyes are open. It's terrible. Hallelujah. So I told the young man, don't send that one, that $100. Because he wanted to send that money for that to service his altar for things to work out well. And here is the person that is leading some in church. Can I tell you this, gentlemen? The deception is in church today. Many born again are born against the gospel. Deception, leading worship, but it's an idol worshiper. Can I ask you, can that song glorify Jesus? Talk to me, somebody. Can that song glorify Jesus? Because, ladies and gentlemen, the container, the person singing is important. If there is no holiness in that person's life, you are just making noise and entertaining people. God does not work with unholy verses. Therefore, if a man should purge himself from the latter, purge himself. An idol worshiper was leading worship in church. Thank God he opened my eye and showed me. And thank God the guy left by himself. It's good. I'm praying. Any agent of darkness assigned to destroy this church, Lord, take them away. Take them away, Lord. Take them away. Lord, cleanse the church with fire. My prayer, Lord Jesus, I give you permission. Clean the church from the pulpit, from me. Clean all this fire. Fire, cleanse us. I told him, don't send the money. He was to send for them to service his altar. If the Holy Ghost did not reveal to me in church, I will never know. Sometimes you deal with people, you think they are who? They protect themselves, but behind they are idol worshippers. Idol worshippers. But they say, Pastor, hallelujah. Pastor, glory to Jesus. But they are idol worshippers. If a person could send money to service his altar, is that person is a typical idol worshipper. I'm not telling stories. I don't want to call names. If I call the name, I will know him. An idol worshiper. May God have mercy on us. The next one is number four is disgrace. Jeremiah chapter number 3, verse 24 to 25. Jeremiah chapter number 3, verse 24 to 25. Jeremiah chapter number 3, verse 24 to 25. Hallelujah. Verse 24 says, from our youth, shameful gods have consumed the fruit of our father's labor. Please listen very well. From our youth, shameful gods, Moji, have consumed the fruit, the labor, the fruits of our father's labor. And he says, their flocks and their herds, their sons and daughters. Verse 25. Let us lie down in our shame. Let our disgrace cover us. An idol worshiper will all end in disgrace, shame. But he who worships Jehovah, he said, I will take away the spirit of the garment of shame and give you the garment of praise, the garment of joy, the garment of holiness. Idol worshippers always end up in shame. Check by the word, they end up in shame and disgrace. So if an idol worshiper expects shame and disgrace, don't say, Jesus, where are you? Change from being an idol worshiper to be a worshiper of Jesus Christ in spirit and in truth. Number five, disfavor. Not favor. Jeremiah 3 verse 13. I don't know why today I'm going back to Jeremiah. Jeremiah 3 verse 13 says, Jeremiah 3 verse number 13. It says, only acknowledge your guilt. You have rebelled against the Lord your God. You have scattered your favors to foreign gods. Did you see that? Please write the scriptures. He said, you have scattered your favor to who? Foreign gods. You carry favor, but because of the deities in your father's house, you have scattered your favors to them. They have swallowed your favor. Therefore, no man, no company favors you. Pastor, pray for me. No. What is your family like? Sometimes we pray wrong prayers, or we pray for wrong people, or wrong reasons. Why? They know they are worshiping idols. They know very well, but they will never tell you. People of God, if you don't know, if the Holy Ghost does not know you or you don't know Him, please be careful, because there's deception in church. Someone say, hear you. Someone say, hear you. Please, I want to submit to you. Cultivate a healthy relationship with Jesus Christ. Cultivate fellowship with the person of the Holy Spirit. Because church in this end time, there's deception from the pulpit. But when the Holy Ghost is present, He will tell you, this is wrong. This is correct. He will project things to you. Test every spirit. How do you test? You must be in the spirit as well to test that spirit. Are we together? Number six, captivity. Captivity. Judges chapter number six. Judges chapter number six. Verse 1, you read down. The Bible said the children of Israel, in fact, they always go into captivity. Why did they leave their place? Why were they into captivity in Babylon or other places? Because of idol worship. I am the Lord your God. I brought you out of Egypt. I brought you out that I may fellowship with you, have a good time with you. You said no. Even in the wilderness, when Moses went up to bring down the Ten Commandments, even in the wilderness, when they saw all the plagues in Egypt, they saw the Red Sea parted in front of their eyes. They saw all the miracles. They saw everything. While Moses went up, was speaking with God. These guys, they turned their back against God and made a calf, a golden calf in the wilderness. A golden calf. Idol worshiping did not start today. Are we together? And God said, Moses, look at the people I'm trying to help. I'm bringing out. It's just because I swear to Abraham. It's a covenant, because I'm a covenant keeping God. I remember my covenant with Abraham. That's why I'm manifesting, because I keep my covenant. It's because of covenant that they were brought out. If He did not promise Abraham, He would never do it today. He could have left them there to die like nobody's. But because of covenant, ladies and gentlemen, whatever there is, I don't worship in their covenant, and covenant speak. Covenant speak. Hallelujah. So they always go to captivity. The Bible said in the book of Judges, chapter number 6, it said, whatever the Israelites planted, what happened? These Midianites will come and scatter and ravish them. Wherever there is idol worship, the people are impoverished. A family or individual that worship idols, they are always poor, bankrupt. Check very well. They were impoverished. Why? Idols were speaking against them. Are we together? Even though Gideon carried, the angel of the Lord said, you are a man, you're a mighty man of valor. Mighty man of valor. You are a mighty man, yes. But the mightiness was not seen outwardly. He carried it inside.
But he could not manifest himself. Why? Because the altars in his father's houses, the altars and the idols in his father's houses, they were speaking against the mightiness he carried. So Gideon could not manifest himself. That's why when the angel appeared to him, he said, me, I'm from the smallest. You see, he was referring his circumstance to his clan, that we are even the small. In fact, we are even small. We are nobodies. He said, no, you carry it. He said, no. He said, okay, let me show you. Unless you destroy the altars of your father's house, you cannot manifest my power. And on every altar, there should be an idol. So the valor, the word of Gideon came up only after he destroyed. God could not use him first. First, you have to destroy the altars in his father's house. Then they could go for battle, and they won, and they prevailed. But if the altars, the idols of the father's house were still erected, they go out for war, they win Israel and they win them. Yeah, even though they were favored, even though they were strong. Why? Because idol worshipping, God does not share his glory with any man. When there's idol worshipping, God will back out. Check your life. Are you worshipping idols? That's why God is not with you. Check your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So the family is going to captivity. It's a pact. Captivity. Number 7, there is no rain. If you're an idol worshiper, there's no rain in your life. If there's no rain, you live in drought. Drought can be spiritual, can be physical. Pastor, I've been working for 5 years, nothing to show. Are you still an idol worshiper? Because there'll be drought. There'll be lack. If they drought means lack of rain. Which means that it can be spiritual rain or physical rain. Therefore, the productivity is denied or decreased, or it's not even there. There's no productivity. There's no. And when there's no, there'll be famine. We can be physical, can be spiritual. If there's famine in your life, what can you do? Spiritual famine. You're a dead man. Or physical famine. So you see that when there's no rain, the wages themselves, your wages, they worked hard. They worked out. Each time they planted, they came and destroyed. They came and uprooted. Pastor, each time I kept money, something will happen. I will spend money. The others will come. Why? Because idols are still involved. Change your foundation. Leave your father's foundation. If you want to go far in life, change your foundation. Someone say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I can hear you say hallelujah. In Judges chapter 6, where we saw, it says, each time they planted their crops, the Midianites will come and they will ravage them. He said, these guys said, number one, they oppressed the Israelites. When there's idol worshiping, the people will be oppressed. Any family that worships idols, they are oppressed spiritually and physically. No matter how skillful you are, they will oppress you. They were oppressed. And the Bible said, each time they planted, they would come and ravish everything. So they were impoverished. So oppression goes through poverty. You didn't get it? You didn't hear me? Oppression goes through poverty. Because when an idol is involved, idol worship is involved, they'll be poor and they'll be in bondage. They go to captivity, nothing to show. All the skills are being swallowed. When Jesus says, I am the Lord, there's no other God beside me. He means change your foundation and come to the sure foundation. Without Jesus, you can never make it. Without the Holy Ghost, you can never make it. Somebody shout, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So, if you look at the very one, when God told Abraham to leave his father's house, father means ancestor. Leave your ancestral tradition. Please, I advise you, leave your so-called tradition. If you want to see your way forward. Leave your ancestral tradition. This is not for you, for them. If you want things to be better for you, God will never share his glory. God can forgive you on his sin. But when it comes to idol worship, that you are worshiping an idol consciously, it means that you are mocking him. Brothers and sisters, if you mock God in worship, you know very well that God hates it. And you are worshiping an idol, means you are mocking God. When you mock God, there's no man that can pray for you. And when you mock God, please be careful. There are things that, or there are places you don't step into, or don't step on God. Don't worship idols and come and worship God. That's a curse. He's waiting for you on the judgment seat. On that day, you please repent. So, what's the neighbor?
Neighbor.
Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Change your ways.
Neighbor.
Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
change your ways. Say, neighbor, change your ways. So Father's tradition keep us into captivity. What is the solution? Someone say solution.
Solution.
I can hear you. Say solution.
Solution.
Isaiah chapter number 45. Isaiah 45, verse number 22 to 23. Isaiah 45, verse number 22 to 23. It says, turn to me and be saved. Turn to me and be saved, all you ends of the earth, for I am God and there is no other. Verse 23. By myself I have sworn, my mouth has uttered in all integrity a word that will not be revoked. Before me every knee will bow and every tongue will confess. Before me is Jehovah. Before Elohim, every tongue will confess and every knee must bow. You must bow first before you confess. What is the solution? Solution is repentance. God is a God of mercy. But if you take the mercy of God in vain, which means you are taking the grace in vain, there's a time mercy expires. The someone who is called merciful, gracious, is the someone who is called judgment. He doesn't share his glory with any man. You are the Lord, very sure name. You will never share your glory with any man. You will never share your glory with anybody. Almighty God, that is your name. You will never share your glory with anybody, even the idols. So God is calling us to the place of repentance. Ladies and gentlemen, friends, solution is to repent. And tell God to help you. Repentance is important. Means change your mindset from this thing. Change away from them. Turn away from them. Cut off from them and come to Jesus. Solution is only in Christ. Idols will never give you solution. But the God I serve, Jesus Christ, He's a way maker. May He give you solution tonight.
Amen.
May He give you solution tonight.
Amen.
Solution is to repent. There is no other God. You have to repent genuinely and sincerely. I came to understand that believers don't repent genuinely. They say it today, Father, I'm sorry. They talk to one and do the same thing. God is not mocked. Whatever a man sowed, that shall he reap. Repentance, come to Jesus. Change from these things. Cut off from them and come to Him and ask for mercy. He's merciful. I say He's merciful.
Amen.
I say He's merciful. Then He's seeking for that person whose heart is touched, whose heart say, Lord, I want to change. Lord, help me to change, to move up from idol worship to worship. Until you get to the point, you say, Lord, help me. He will not help you. Ladies and gentlemen, don't delay yourself with idols. Anybody that worships idols becomes like idols themselves. When you worship idols, you become idols themselves. Therefore, your identity is changed spiritually. God does not know you. Jesus does not know you. When you lose that to receive the idols, that's why there's no favor from God. The solution is in repentance. Repent. Repent. For the kingdom of heaven. Jesus is calling us to the place of repentance. Holiness is vital. You must repent and cut off from these things. These things will put you on the broad road. There is a way that seems right to a man. At the end of it, destruction. Other worshiping puts you on the broad road for destruction. But Jesus Christ, the sure foundation, said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Rise up, Jeffrey.